I never had any particular time where I found it difficult to go on. There was always things to paint.
I don't know whether in the first place I thought of even having an exhibition, but I just decided to find out how much work she really actually did. She had basically, ever since I grew up, filled the houses of all of her children, the grandchildren's houses, I think there were 10 of us, great-grandchildren, and I just thought, this is an incredible body of work.
This is all of my grandmother's artwork, most of it. All packed up to go in. 5 years of work, 50 years of work, 5 years of my work.
I wrote to everyone in the family, and I wrote to people who she had records of that intermittently she had sold artwork through over the past 20 years, and asked them to just take some pictures. They didn't have to be professional or anything. Send me pictures, and I sent a little form in terms of how big it is, who the owner was, just to really catalog it. And I got back, I got a notebook this thick. A painter said, this is incredible. You know, and until I had kind of seen it in that form, I really didn't appreciate the diversity and the volume of work, you know, that she had created. So at that point, I decided I wanted to at some point mount some kind of exhibition.
See this? This was packed. Look at this.
My God.
It was going to outer space.
Look at this.
This package was going to the moon. We're ready to take this exhibition to the moon.
Who is this?
This is Jean Grant.
Jean Grant has all this work? No, they're just...
Dad, do you have Jean Grant stickers?
Yeah.
Oh, but they have his name on them.
Oh, God.
Look at these. Look at this. This is made from wine labels.
You see that when I...
It's a dancer.
Oh,
no, look, this
God.
Is for Norma and Naomi Franklin. Which is... Oh, hi,
Ben. Nice
isn't that nice?
Yeah, who is Naomi? Oh, that's
Naomi.
Gorgeous.
This is Norma 20 years ago on her 70th birthday.
She just arrived. How are you?
Eric, do you have to put this painting in? I don't know, there's something... In me, I can't make a big fuss over something that I feel. I know it's valuable, this experience. I'm not going into ecstasies over it because it's not my nature to be that way.
I thought you were going to come in here and be really overwhelmed of seeing 45 years of your work all around this room. Enjoy it a little bit.
All right.
Not everything is perfect. Okay? But look at the bigger picture. Look at what this room is filled with. I think it's absolutely incredible. You want to know something? I walked in here yesterday and Lynn and I started to cry.
I don't blame you.
You bitch.
Well, part of what I think that we were fighting for, you know, when it was really us against you at times, was really that also the painter could be so close to the work at times that it's hard for you to really be totally objective about your work. And there were certain things that you might not like or don't think are so valuable for the show that other people can appreciate, you know, and do think are good pieces. And I think that's what we fought for as well.
We've laid some things out here, not for exact things necessarily that are going to be in the show, where they're going to be hung. We have general ideas, conceptually.
All right, you don't have to take the time. I'm willing to go along with what you say and do, but there's some things I don't want in the show. I don't want those, that A, B, C, D thing.
I think that's
something?
One of my favorites.
I think that's
you're going to have to compromise, okay? You're going to have to trust us, and we're going to have to do this together. All right, and if there are things that we all feel strongly about, we're going to have to come to conclusions about it. Otherwise, I'll tell you something. I'm going to hang the show without you because I've got two days to hang the show.
All right.
We've got hundreds of people coming here on Saturday. I won't have to unless I have to.
Stop.
Get on up, get up, get on up, get up, get on up, stay on the scene, get on up, like a sex machine, get on up, get up, get on up, stay on the scene, get on up, like a sex machine, get on up, wait a minute, shake your arm, then use your palm, stay on the scene, like a sex machine, you gotta have the feeling, sure as your bone. Get it together, right on, right on. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up.
Extremely close.
You know that I'm right. You
no,
can't even admit it.
I don't.
Look at how much better it looks this way.
Oh, I don't know that it does. Put it on the side and each player's a little better.
She knows that I'm right.
No, I don't.
Do you like this one, Norma? You want this in the show?
Well, why not? I didn't mean to say that, but I only got
just
the whole damn show and those of them.
I think we should make this wall a ballet wall. That's the solution. Oh my God, why didn't I think of that? We did yesterday, didn't we?
No.
We can have the ballet wall over here with this, Norma, with your ballet things and your collages and the posters. We'll find it. You know what? Maybe we'll put the running man in the front on its own. Now, Larry, I think, was, he was very quiet, you know?
I don't think you're listening. You're not hearing
me. I heard you.
What am I saying?
Wait until everything's up.
No, I'm saying just wait until we get the walls at least semi-structured. Then you can see what goes where. We'll take something from this wall and put it there. We'll take something from, but now you don't know because it's all laying around.
Well, I knew where he was going the first place.
No, you don't. You said to put it there, right?
No, well, Larry, first of all, this wall was supposed to be the best of my oils,
no,
right?
There's the best of your oils in there, darling.
This is, I consider one of the best things I've ever done.
Yeah, but sir, they have to work together. We have a lot of stuff and a little bit of space.
Well,
if you wanted to take this down and say we're only going to show 40 paintings, we wouldn't have a problem in the world. But there are 221 paintings.
But I know the important ones and where they should
They're going to be, but you don't know until they're up and we'll move it around.
Well, I know where they should go.
Well, then you'll have the final say once it's up.
You know, Lynn's my granddaughter, and I love her deeply. But when it came to hanging the paintings, I forgot all about that.
We were doing great before. You missed it, but Jeb and I have been working all morning. We got so much done, didn't we, Matthew?
And Deba, he just looked on in astonishment. He seemed to plod along, you know, plodding.
What do you think, Jeb? You have no thoughts about it?
Yeah, just a hired help, I mean. I don't think.
Her energy level is, it's inspiring, but it's like bittersweet in a way.
But I don't like that there. It looks terrible there.
You put it there.
Huh?
You put it there.
I didn't put it there.
And it's been there all day.
No, it hasn't.
Don't make Carol start running around.
But she don't mind doing it.
The thing is, Lynn, if she doesn't like it, who's going to change it? But Mama, what's gonna go there?
Here, put this one over there, that strong one on the end.
Let's see. No, let's see, Lynn. Let's see what she's talking
Lynn,
about.
Lynn, we have to get these up. Don't get upset about it.
Look,
it's
Lynn,
nothing personal.
Right, look at this, Lynn.
Lynn, it's
what?
Nothing personal. If you're gonna take that attitude, we'll never get these up.
Well, then I understand that this is
that's much better.
We can do this all day. She won't be here. That's
tomorrow.
Where are you going to be?
I'm going to get a manicure.
Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Stay on the scene. Get on up like a sex machine. Get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Stay on the scene. Get on up like a sex machine. Get on up. Get up, get on up. Stay on the scene. Get on up like a sex machine. Get on up. Wait a minute. Shake your arm. Then use your palm. Stay on the scene. Like a sex machine. You got to have the feeling. Sure as your bone. Get it together. Right on, right on. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up.
Relationship with my family altogether.
Now back there, above it, that's it. Above it. That's it. We've got to use that wall.
How was that?
That's great.
No, we're not discussing this wall right now.
No.
We've got this problem.
I just don't want to.
But Grandma, you said that 15 times, and if you're going to detract people, I need his help somewhere
else.
I know what your feeling is, and when we get to this wall, we'll deal with that. I wish you would turn this way and help us over here. Okay? This is where we need your help.
All right.
You will fine-tune them, okay, before it's finished. In the meantime, what you're doing is obstructing the work from going forward.
This is just... I mean, you have to just work with the best payment you have. This is not your best thing.
Well, it's all right. There's nothing wrong.
Yeah, but you,
this is not going
to go up. Yeah, but you, that's right. But you have choices to make. So let's take this out.
God, everything's getting me nervous.
What are you going to put up there?
Wait, I'll go to the painting. Find it.
Where?
Staircase painting goes over there.
So let's put it up. You have to see how that looks. You want this up there?
Will you do something else?
No. You know, to me, the creative process and anything that I've ever done is a difficult process. It's a painful process. It takes you into the darkest, ugliest places to only come out into, you know, the brightest kind of places, too.
I'm capable of fixing that wall.
You, maybe yes, maybe no, all right?
Well, then you do everything.
The purpose of this wall is getting wrecked up. Everything is going like this. These look great up here, and these are going to stay up here. I like them.
I didn't put it there in the beginning, and I don't want it there.
Then what do you want there
it's
now?
It's too delicate.
What do you want there
I
now?
I wanted to change it with that.
No, she was putting it in that corner. What is going in that spot?
That's fine.
Hold it. Maybe that's not the place for it, Carol.
Yes.
What was over here? What was over there?
That light blue one, and it didn't look good there. I have you.
No, over here?
Yeah.
That's something missing from over there.
And that Eric, take him away.
What?
Take him away. We're fixing it fine. We had
this is going up.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and
myself. What a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
It's like you would look at this work and you would say, my God, what joy, you know, what liveliness, what positivity. You know, this person must have, this really on the surface wasn't, you know, really part of Norma's, you know, my grandmother's day-to-day life.
I don't know what to say. I'm so overwhelmed with the beauty of everything that you've done. And there, you were so modest about it. There was no way anyone could tell.
I guess I should talk about the first time I ever met Norma. She was lying down on the couch. She had just come in from the dentist, and she was very anxious about the experience she just went through. And it's hard to imagine that all these paintings and the vitality that went into them was the same woman.
It was like magic. When I took up that brush, I can't tell you the kind of feeling I had about it. And I said to myself, well, I'm going to show them all. Not anybody here is going to do any better than I am. I really got very cocky about it.
I've known Norma more years than I care to mention because that will betray my own age. However, I've seen a lot of her paintings. Some of them are mediocre, some are excellent, some I love, some I don't like, but there's an amazing collection here, and you find everything you want. And as to the collages, I think she excels in those, because they're terrifically creative and artistic and beautiful and exciting, period. Enough? What more do you want to say? However, the colors of some are magnificent. Some are a little, there are colors that I don't vibrate to, but I like things I can vibrate to. And that's the story of my liking for pictures or not liking them.
My name is Galina, and I'm from Russia. In fact, I was passing by. I wanted to see the Russian exhibition, which is a block away from here. But I got quite interested in what I saw passing in the window. In Russia, major emphasis is usually on the content of every art object, on its social meaning, on its prophecy. But here, I would say the whole meaning and the whole message is this incredibly beautiful color and combination of colors. I tried to see as much of American art as I could, and it's one of the most remarkable exhibitions I saw lately.
Your collages are really good. I mean, I can't say enough things about them. I mean, your imagination is phenomenal, and what you've done with them, little tiny gems. I mean, it's like when you think there are postage stamps worth $250,000, I mean, these are absolutely fabulous, darling. I hope you just keep painting, and I'll kick your butt if you don't. When we met 8 years ago, I bet, or maybe you knew, it would be love at first sight. I didn't, but we've had a wonderful friendship, a wonderful relationship, and probably the most important thing that you've taught me is when you love someone, you never stop loving that person.
So we went up to Provincetown together about, gosh, I guess it was about 35 years ago, she and I spent the summer, and that's where she started with her work. And just to see what's evolved over these years is just like even amazes me.
The show is absolutely marvelous. She has a tremendous variety, enormous talent, and a huge oeuvre. Enviable and just to be marveled at. I'm proud to know her.
I think this is an honor to be here at this show. The fact that this woman has created such wonderful pieces for everybody to enjoy. Not only that, her own
her own sense of beauty, her sense of wanting to share, and her ability, by the way, she's a very able woman. I myself am a sculptor. And so my appreciation of it is heightened by what I know as an artist, you know. And she's a lovely person. She's a very nice lady to look at, too, you know.
Well, Norma, it's been great. I really enjoyed it. I always enjoy having lunch with you. It was a great experience, nice and relaxing in your studio. And right now, I'm just really enjoying the people and all the psychic energy that I feel, that I see. It's just really been nice.
It's amazing the quantity of the work that she's done, although I respect the quality more than the quantity. I think the quality is there. I met Norma in 1950 in Provincetown. I'm an artist, and we met there, and we've been very good friends since then. I've been following her work all along, and very impressed with her.
The fact is, the family is still talking. I'm still married. My mother-in-law is still alive. So from that point of view, it's been a success.
I love you, Muzzy. You're a doll girl, and you're talented, and you're all the things I always wanted to be and never could.
I'm amazed, and I'm very, very proud of my great-grandmother for this show. I don't even know what to say. I can't put it into words. It's just incredible, and as everyone else has said to me as a painter, I have a lot to live up to.
I think everybody here that I've spoken to has really emphasized how magnificent these pictures are. And I'm really proud of all that you've done, and it's been a privilege to be in your family.
I tried twice suggesting to Eric where to put a painting up, and I said, Eric, don't you think? And he said, no. And I knew that was it, so I went home.
I love you, Dana.
I'm exhausted.
She's exhausted.
It's just been awesome. It's like putting the pieces of a puzzle together, you know, from all over the country. And it's given everybody so much joy and brought the family together. And, you know, it's, not only has it made Norma happy, it's made all of us happy. It's just been unbelievable. And the turnout, I mean, these people, and a lot of them strangers, have kind of come in off the street going, what is this? You know, why does this feel so special? Why does this feel so good? I think the energy here is amazing, you know, that Eric has created, and it has drawn people together, and people can't leave, you know, they come in and they want to stay, and everybody wants to be a member of the family. I've come up to a few people and I've said, are you fam? And they said, no, but we'd like to be.
I just want to say that I'm very happy to be here. In fact, I'm happy to be anywhere. But. And I'm amazed at what I'm seeing here. Most boys or men don't have too much of good opinions or favorable opinion about their sisters, but I'm really impressed. And from now on, I'll give her all the appreciation and flattery that she deserves.
It's been a great opportunity to bring our whole family together, and I'm so glad that we're all together here to wish you a 90th birthday. Happy 90th birthday, and to see all your great works of art.
I just think this tribute to you is the greatest thing that's ever happened in this family.
So great to get together with the Smiths and the Horowitzes and the Goldstones and everybody we've seen, and it's very special to us.
The secret to my success with this is that anything that he said do, I did the opposite. And that's how it worked.
Right, and I knew it all the time, so I got him to do everything I wanted. Eric, you have to not give me a kiss. See? I'm proud of him.
Thank this you, would, Dad. You're a would, big help.
This would not have happened without him.
He picks me up off the floor every time I fall down and I don't feel like I can get up.
And then I throw him down again.
I've had a wonderful time.
Good.
And I think Grandma has too. This has been a wonderful tribute for her and her family.
Well, I love my grandma, and I thought the show is excellent, and that all her paintings are very colorful, and I love the ones of the ballet, and I also love the little boxes a lot, and I just think it was put together excellently, and Grandma really helped put it together, too, I hear.
Yeah, well, it wasn't really a crisis. It was a family interacting, as we have always. But if you notice, the passions don't last long. We get angry, but not for long. We also make up quickly. And I think that keeps us going.
She didn't move one painting.
Grandma?
I would have liked to.
Grandma? Grandma,
did you hear that?
I love you.
I love you. I think it was great. Really great, honey.
I love you.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They learn much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself,
this was really an act of giving, you know, an unconditional kind of love and giving. And it's the most gratifying, satisfying experience that one can have. And Norma taught me that. She didn't produce any of these things expecting anyone to do anything. It was just she wanted to give. I'd like to dedicate this song to Grandma Norma, who I love very much.
Crazy. I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew you'd love me as long as you wanted, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself?